We are on our way to sleep to work on my fall book for next year, Home for Christmas. One of the most interesting animals in the sea is the whale. Since my new book is set in Sweden, I thought it would be fun to head off on our trip for the research by ship. And along the way, I hoped I might see a few whales. What I'm looking for is the whale's blow, which often you see before you even see the whale. And what happens is that when it comes up to the surface, it lets out a big breath of air and that vaporizes. And the blow can be up to 10 feet tall. It just hangs in the air for a few minutes. So once you spot that, you know you've got a whale, and then it may come up again soon to take another breath. And when you're close to the whale, it will make a noise. You'll hear this kind of noise. It's very exciting to see that. And then sometimes you'll get a glimpse of the black back as it rolls down to dive. And that's what I'm going to draw for you today. I'm going to draw you a humpback whale. And that's the most exciting whale to watch on a whale watch because, first of all, they're very curious and they'll come up close to boats. And they also are found all over the world, especially in where I live, which is outside of Boston. And there's a place called, there's a low area of the ocean. It's like a gravel bank underneath. And that's where a lot of the whales come to feed in the springtime. And that's where we went and watched the whales. And we actually saw a mother and her calf. I'm going to draw you a humpback whale, and I hope that you will follow along with me. And I'm going to start with two really simple shapes. And I'm thinking of these shapes as being like a soup bowl that's upside down. First this soup bowl is going to be right side up, and then there's going to be one on top of it. So it's like a dome, but a very flattened dome. And I'm going to put my paper on the horizontal too. I just want you to do that as well. And then here's the soup. I'm going to draw this a second time, but just so that you get the idea, here's the first soup bowl. And then about maybe halfway, I'm going to do another soup bowl. It might be a little bit shallower, like this, and put it on top. So those are going to be the two basic shapes of this huge, huge whale. So I'm going to put this aside now and start again on my paper. And I'm going to use my pencil to show first the first soup bowl. And this is going to show the head and the main body of the whale. And then the smaller one is going, or a thinner soup bowl is going to go on top, and it's going to show the back end of the whale. Because this humpback whale, before it dives, it kind of curves its body up and uses its energy to dive. And that's why they call it humpback. And I wanted to show you this from the side because whales are really hard to draw. They're so unusual, we don't see them very often. And when we do, it's just usually their head sticking out of their water. It's very rare that you'd be in a scuba suit and swimming next to a whale. So I've been relying on a lot of books that tell us about whales in order to know what the whale looks like. Now I've got these two shapes, and this is gonna be the whale's body. His tail's gonna be there. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm gonna refine his snout or her snout. You really can't tell if a whale is a boy or a girl until they have a calf. So I'm just making it go down a little bit, and then right about there is where his blowhole is gonna be. So I'm just gonna make a little dent there, and that will kind of help me when I am working on the whale to know where that is. And then I'm gonna carve a little piece right in there because this is where his jaws come in, and then they come down. And now if I'm taking the first dome and I'm like halfway down, halfway in this distance here, and then halfway down the soup bowl, I'll put a little dot, because that's where his flipper is going to extend down from. And they call that a pectoral flipper. And that's the shape. It kind of curves back towards the tail, and then gets a little bit thinner where it attaches to the whale. And this front surface is going to have some bumps on it. So have some fun making a wavy line going down that flipper, because it has those bumps in it, which makes it, that's what a humpback whale would have. And then right where the skin is attaches, that you could show some little lines there, because that's where it attaches. And then I guess we'll put his mouth in next. I'm saying him, but it
could be a girl. And this goes, follows along the front of it, top of its forehead, all the way to where the blowhole is, and then it takes a downward turn. What an interesting shape for a mouth. And then where is his eye? Wouldn't you think it'd be up here? Oh no, it's way down here in the corner of where the mouth is. And it looks small in comparing with his body, which is over 50 feet long. I call this the 50-50 whale because it's 50 feet long as an adult and it lives to be about 50 years old. But his eye is very small because it's a great huge animal. And then you can put a little few wrinkles around his eye. And people say that when you're looked at by a whale, you almost get a shiver through yourself because you get the feeling of this very intelligent being looking at you. And a lot of times whales will come right up to a boat and sky hop, which is to put their head out of straight up out of water, and they'll look at you with that eye, which is very big when you see it up close. And then, let's see, I'm going to work a little bit more on the body of the whale. Here goes this upper, the lower part of his, where his tummy is, and then it gets a little bit thinner where his tail is going to join, and it gets complicated up here, because very at the very top of this rise, make a little hill, it's just like a fatty hump there, and then on top of that fatty hump is a little fin, and you will see that in the water, that little fin on the hump, and then you know it's a humpback whale. And then just before you get to the tail, you can make a few more of those ripples in bumps that go down his back. So he's making this beautiful motion. And then the tail is very thin before it gets to the tail. Now a fish's tail would go sideways like this, but oh no, we're not going to do that. We're going to make flukes. So the flukes join right in here, and we have to show them kind of at an angle, and they go like this. They attach up there, and they swing back like that. I'm just gonna work on that a little bit more because I didn't make the angle quite right. But they go in, and we'll draw another whale sounding nearby, which we'll get to see another view of those beautiful flukes, because that's one of the ways you can identify this beautiful humpback species of whale, because their flukes have got a pattern on them, and each one is different, and that's how scientists can identify the different whales. And they, when you go off in a whale boat, they always want to see the photographs you've taken of the flukes as they go down in their dives, because then they can look in their records and find this fingerprint, only it's not a fingerprint, it's a tail print, the pigment in the tail. It will tell them what whale it is. So in the whale watch that we went on, we found out what the whale's name was, and they were very excited, the biologist, because she had a calf with her, and they realized that she was a girl, because they had seen the whale before, but they did not know if it was a boy or a girl until she came with her calf. Now underneath, let's say this is the tummy, but the throat area right here, you can make some lines that kind of follow along, and you can let your pencil go darker and then lighter, because those are pleats in her skin. And those will expand when she's opens her mouth. They have a huge gape, which is the distance when their jaws lift up to get the krill or the prey that they're eating, and they fill this area with water, and then they filter all the good stuff down into their tummies, for that's their food. So the one other thing that is kind of fun to add is, you know, people have freckles. Well, whales have tubercles, and they're like little bumps that go all around their snout, which is what you call the top of the whale's mouth, and then down here too. And you can just make a little round circles, and they would look almost like little peas, black peas on their skin. And those are their carbuncles. And then this whale is, I'm going to make one that lives in the North Atlantic, and they have flippers that are almost pure white. And then they have, then the rest of their body is pigmented black, and they have almost like a little design, almost like a spotted horse. It's uneven here, and it'll go down in there. Flukes on the top will most likely be black, and this fin will be black, and then their face will be black, but their tummy will be white. And then the ones in the North Pacific tend to have black on their flippers. So now I'm going to use my marker and just outline, the ship is rolling a little bit. I'm going to outline the whale's body now. So there's the blowhole, and you can see a few of those tubercles. And there's the mouth that comes down. And his eye. And one of the things that's interesting about these humpbacks is that they usually in groups of one or two, but once in a while, if the food is particularly good, you can see maybe 10 or 12, like my friends, the Doggetts and the Clems, who took some photographs. I think I'm going to be able to show the film that they took a little later, these beautiful animals feeding. And the thing that's interesting about the way that they catch their prey is they make a net out of bubbles. Doesn't that sound impossible? Well, they do. They twirl around underneath the water, blowing slowly out their blowholes and make a little ring of bubbles. And they twist around faster and faster, and that net of bubbles gets closer and closer together until all these animals that are floating in the water, swimming in the water, really, they're like little fish, or they could be those little shrimps, and then they're concentrated in one place because of these bubbles, and then they go up and eat them up. And that's how they're able to sustain these huge bodies. That, of course, you know that they are covered with thick skin, and then underneath is a layer of fat called blubber, and that's how they can withstand the temperatures of the cold ocean. They're like in a great big wetsuit. And so this is the top of this whale will be black and the bottom will be white. So next I'm going to use my paint and I'm going to do a little bit of shading on the tummy of the whale because I want to, this is where he's white, or she's white. So I just want that to look like it's rounded a little bit. And I'm going right over my pencil. And if this was a finished drawing for a book that I was doing, I would probably take the trouble to erase that. And so this, of course, is going to be white too, because it's the flippers you see when they come up to blow their air out of their lungs. You'll see the flipper, and it's quite muscular and really long. You'd never expect it to be that long because I think we're used to fish, and each whale is a little bit different in the way that they look. And now the top is kind of a dark black color, and actually I just saw a pilot whale 2 days ago on the ocean, and I was looking for blows, and as I was looking, all of a sudden I look up and there is the back of a whale, and I looked it up in my book. And it seemed like it was most likely to be a pilot whale because it was kind of on the smallish side. It was very black. And I was looking at the fin, and the fin was much bigger than the fin on this whale, which is, it's on a hump, but it's quite small. So now this might take a little while to get all that black showing on that pigment. And I'll try to I'll try to leave a little space to show that he's kind of shiny. And whale watching has been quite an industry in the area where I am because of this Stedman's Bank where the whales congregate to feed. And it's pretty exciting to think that those whales are out there in quite large numbers and that we live near one of the most popular feeding places for whales in the world. And then they like to go in the cold waters to feed, but then when they want to breed and have their babies, calves, have their calves, then they go to tropical waters. So they might go to the Caribbean, or they might go to South Sea Islands, or they might go to Hawaii. And we were able to see some whales when we were in Hawaii, in Maui, where there's a lot of whales. And those whales were doing their sky hopping. And the other thing, I was saying about how they're very popular whales to watch? It's also because they'll sometimes jump right out of the water, or they'll hit the water with their flukes, or they'll hit the water with their flippers and splash it. And they No one really knows why, if they're communicating with people on the boat, so they're communicating with other whales. But it's all, no matter what they're doing, it seems like they're very intelligent animals that are definitely trying to communicate with somebody, probably other whales, but they do come up and look at boats. And a lot of times people will have very interesting encounters with whales. And some people say that it really changes them when they have a contact with one of these animals because they sense their intelligence. And I've only really seen three kinds of whales. I've seen the humpback. I've seen the gray whale when I was in California. I was just walking down a beach and then I saw this huge shape come out of the water. What was that? And then I just thought I was imagining something. And because the water was really rough and we're on the beach. Then we got up in this outlook and we saw the sprays, the blows, and I said, oh my gosh, it's whales. And then of course we saw signs after that. Now my paintbrush is a little small for this because I really need to get a lot of show how black this whale is. And what I do is I mix blue and brown together. And so I would probably have been better off if I had, you know, a great big brush. But I'll show you a little trick, which I've got putting more and more black on. And then I'm just going to take water. This brush now has nothing but water on it. And I'm just going to go over those little tubercles and make them stand out a little bit by taking some of the paint off. Like you always think an artist puts paint on the paper. Well, sometimes artists take paint off the paper. And that gives the illusion that there's little bumps there. And then maybe I'll do the same thing right under his mouth so you can see maybe the light is hitting that so you can get a better idea of where his mouth is. And perhaps I'll do the same thing around his eyes. So right now I'm taking paint off. So here's his mouth up there. I don't think it looks quite dark enough. So I'm just gonna darken that a little bit because that's his mouth, not down there. Actually, the way I'm gonna try to fix that is I'm gonna try to bring that down a little bit, so it doesn't look like his mouth is down here like a giant shark. And then I'll work a little bit on modeling the underside of the whale. And I guess a little bit more on getting the skin a little bit darker. And they are mammals, aren't they? I'm sure you know that, but that means that they give milk to their babies and that they have very sparse hairs on them. I think that the hairs are very small and you don't see them very easily. And maybe they just have them when they're little. Find out more about that. But I know that's the definition of a mammal, that they have to have hair someplace on them. So I'm just going to color in a little bit with my marker and just get some, making them look a little bit darker color. I'm just about finished, but I'm going to do something that's going to surprise you at the end, because what I'm going to do is, because of this animal's habit of making this hump in its back as it turns to dive down into the depths to go fishing again, and that's why you call it humpback, I'm just going to turn my paper just ever so slightly, and I'm going to make a line of where the ocean will be. So this is where his, where did I put it? Right here. That's where his blowhole is going to be. I'm going to put a line right like this, and you just usually just see the fin and then where it blows and maybe the tip of its mouth. So I've got to turn it even further. And then this will be where the blow will be. And it's fountain shaped. And if he's 50 feet long and the blow is 10 feet, I'll make it about a fifth of the size of this animal. So you'll see, this is what you'd see if you were in a boat. You'd see this little bit right here and then you'd see the blow. And this one has got a single blow, and some whales, well, each whale has its own distinctive shape, and this is kind of fountain-shaped, and it's a big bushy blow, that's how it's described. But some whales will have two nostrils, and then it will have, you'll see two sprays, and some go straight up in a stream, and some go forward. I think the sperm whales blow goes forward. And then in the olden days, whalers would see that and they'd know what kind of whale it was from a distance, which is kind of a terrible thought because I don't like to think of these animals having being killed by people because they're such magnificent, intelligent creatures. So there's the blue of the ocean. And I'll do a little bit in the front here. And then last of all, we'll make a friend nearby that will have, we'll just see the flukes. So you're imagining the water covering, this would have to be very clear water to see a whale like that. But we can imagine that that's a little bit murkier underwater. And this is what you'd see right there, is those little two pieces. And then here off in the distance is one of the other whales that is sounding, which means taking a big dive. And there's the flukes that go like that. And since this is a humpback whale, it's going to have a pattern on its flukes. And so we'll make it a little, this is like the one I saw. It had like a little bit of white on either side. And so then that would be how you could identify it, because no one else would have it exactly like this one. Maybe it has like a little raggedy place on either side. Oh, and I forgot to say the trailing edge, this edge right here of the flukes, is a little raggedy on all humpback whales. And then this part is very thin, and sometimes like it might have a little dot there, and we say, oh yeah, that's the one with the dot. And someone gets to name them. I don't know who gets to name it. And so this one has just had done its blow, and now it's going to sound. So now artists should always sign their work. So I'm going to put my name and wish that I had made this a little bit blacker. But I do like the way that those carbuncles came out and the way that you can see his eye kind of looking to the side as if he's noticing maybe that there's a boat there. Well, there's my whale drawing. And I'd like to follow this in my video by showing you some video that my friends Nina and Jean Doggett and Bob Clem took off Cape Cod from their boat. And I don't know if you could ever sense the kind of excitement that you feel when you're actually seeing these animals close up. But just if you can just imagine yourself, you know, maybe 10 feet right at eye level with these animals, you might get a little sense of it.